live here at the Schollmeyer Arena, ready for the start of this one. It's the Horned Frogs, of course, of the Jacksonville State Gamecocks. There you see the head coach of Jacksonville State. Ray Harper is a guy who has won everywhere he's been. Most recently at Western Kentucky. In fact, there were some, John, that were shocked that he was fired at Western Kentucky. Because he had done a pretty good job there. Yeah, won a bunch of ball games.
3 20-win seasons, and he's been successful. Also won some national championships at Kentucky Wesleyan and at Oklahoma City University. But he also has some ties to Texas. We'll get into that later on. Actually played at UT back in the day.
Two veteran guards, Greg Tucker, Eric Durham, can really score the basketball for him. And there you see Jamie Dixon and his staff. And his starting lineup, Kavar Shepherd's been good. Brandon Parrish back in the starting lineup. His 100th game as a Horned Frog here for Parrish, and the tap controlled by TCU.
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see how they work Parrish in early. He's been coming off the bench and been very effective that way.
Fisher quickly doesn't get the roll here, does Jalen. Of the Frogs with the offensive rebound. TCU's been a pretty good rebounding team here early on, John, in their first couple of games.
Yeah, they really have, especially on the offensive end. One thing Jamie Dixon mentioned today was he wanted to see more defensive rebounding out of his team tonight. He was not real fired up about what happened the other night against Alabama State.
There's Bane for three. How about that? Picks up right where he's been leaving off, John. 16 points a game right now for the freshman.
Yeah, coming off that 19-point game the other night against Alabama State. He looks effortless, Brian, and he's got a lot of talent.
Turn around baseline right goes. We talked about this big fellow who can score, Narbitas Gija.
Yes, 15 points a game, leading scorer for Jacksonville State. Made it look easy right there. He is their only true center at 6'10". After that, their size drops off quite a bit.
Parrish, entry pass now, Shepherd. He'll back and spin on him with a jump hook this time off the legs.
Boy, nice job there. Changing hands with the basketball after the spin and the right block. Back down, Gigas.
And you know, Coach Dixon has purposely limited Kavar's minutes here early on in the season. In fact, Shepherd in those first two games only averaging about 16 minutes a game.
And I want to keep him fresh. He's very impressed early on with Kavar Shepherd, calls him the anchor of the defense.
Well, the efficiency with which he is playing right now, 12 points in those 16 minutes to start the season. Three-pointer goes here.
It's Eric Durham, Brian. He likes the three. Made last year 50 threes on the year. Had a game against Tennessee Martin last year. He made 8 threes. You'll see more of that.
Parrish for three to answer and knocks it down in his first start of the year for Brandon Parrish.
Nice job by Parrish right there. Sizes it up, knocks it down. Tried to rattle out, but stayed in.
Both teams starting out hot here tonight in Fort Worth at the Schollmeyer Arena. Rare Friday night edition of basketball here in TCU. And a steal here. Defense creating it here. See if they create offense from Bane to the rim. And the freshman misses.
Well, he may have gotten fouled, Brian, but no call there. They're letting him play, Tom O'Neill and his crew.
Durham runs it up here. Drum right. He's just backing it in now here. Parrish and the flip out for the jumper from the free throw line. Intermediate jumper there that doesn't go for Cunningham, but a new shot clock now for Jacksonville State.
Now Jacksonville State, this lineup, these starting five are pretty decent size, Brian. It's when they go to the bench that they get small in a hurry.
Here's Drumright in the lane for the floater that doesn't go, and the rebound ripped out of there by Parrish again.
Good defense right there. Help defense. You saw the Frogs collapse there, try to deny the rim.
3 minutes into this first half, runs with a two-point advantage. Fisher dribbles it off his leg to Parrish. You hear Coach Jamie Dixon in the background, John. It's a positive style that he brings here. He's always coaching play after play after play.
Never sits down. He's in the middle of the game. He's in the middle of every practice, too.
And that's a good call there by Tom O'Neill. An offensive foul here on Malik Trent to use that forearm to gain an advantage.
They're trying to create a little bit of space there, and the Frogs with the foul there. And a little dribble with the left hand and the push. Again, working against Greg Tucker there.
John, it's been over a year since we've last seen this gentleman on the floor for TCU. That's Kenrich Williams, who's back into the lineup. Jamie Dixon, happy to see it, of course. He is Mr. Diversity for this group, as Williams.
He can do it all. He can shoot inside. He can play power ball inside.
He just backs it in, and his jump hook goes to tie this game up. Now it's 7.
Good play there. I'd feed him the ball as much as you can, Brian. He's very, very effective inside.
Out of Lithuania.
By way of Midland College.
Tallahassee Community College. Has a heavily stamped pass. Here's Williams.
He does.
Rebound on the miss. Parrish for another 3-ball. Knocked it into Brandon. Second 3 in the hand.
Boy, nice and solid right there. Ball coming out of his hand nicely. His second 3. He's fired up to get the start.
Williams out front. Working defensively. Extra pass to the corner here. Send it back out front. Now does Tucker. Cunningham didn't take the jumper. There it goes. This time for the corner for Durham. And another offensive rebound here for Jacksonville State. They make the Frogs pay with Drumright's jumper there, a 3 to answer. Yeah,
they've had a couple possessions here early on where they've gotten offensive rebounds and put it back in.
Parrish out front now to Jalen Fisher. Kendrick Williams in the lane. Forces one here from 10, but there's the follow for Bain. Desmond Bain, who plays a lot taller, John, than he is.
Yeah, at 6'5", he just goes right up and over Eric Durham for the putback. Those are huge rebounds right there. Nice job by Bain. Making himself felt early here in his TCU career.
2-point advantage right now for the Frogs. Still looking for our first media timeout of this half. You'll get it right here. Shepherd slaps it away. So pretty good start, actually, for both ball clubs on the offensive end. 2-point lead right now for TCU here. Game number 3, 14:39 left in the half. Frogs leading it here on the Gamecocks. For John, you mentioned his run at Kentucky Wesleyan and Oklahoma City. This is a guy who's been around and had a good run going at Western Kentucky, as we mentioned.
Yeah, and just had a 1 year of 15-12, and they decided that was enough and let him go. Kind of amazing there, but he was a very good player, Brian. I remember him when he was a freshman at Texas. He played there for 2 years, played for Abe Lemons, and was the freshman of the year in the Southwest Conference back in 1981.
There you see that career record. Look at that, 449 and 126. 75% of his games he has won him.
That is a puzzler, but at the same time, a great hire for Jacksonville State.
Jamie Dixon, of course, you see that mark. And we continue to brag on. He started 2-0 here to start the season for TCU. Game number 3 here tonight. Here's a deep 3 out of the timeout with 2 on the shot clock. It doesn't go, and a rebound for the Frogs. Alex Robinson on the floor right now for TCU. Operating as a point guard. He is in for Fisher. Bronzianski's in as well for Kavard Shepherd. And there's a jump hook in the corner that doesn't go for Bronzianski. And back the other way now will come.
Good look right there on the right block. Bronzianski likes that little jump hook.
Gamecocks here gets this man-to-man. One of 2 Division I schools that have that moniker. Blocked here by Bronzianski on the attempt from Jakara Cross.
Boy, more help defense sagging down, reading the shot, and pressing it against the glass.
Robinson now Parrish for another 3. That one's going to be off the mark. Back in the Gamecocks. Dish here, and Tucker loses a handle on it, but it caroms off the drum right. 2-point TCU lead. Aegis will back in now here on Bronzianski. There's Bain with another rebound.
Boy, good defense right there. Bronzianski let him move, but didn't foul.
Bain for 3. Freshman off the mark. Shot it a little flat-footed. Rebound here, and is this going to be a travel? It is. Frogs will retain possession of it.
Well, Kendrick Williams made that happen right there, Brian. He was jumping, lunging, trying to get that rebound, knock the ball loose, and force the travel. Great effort right there. Frogs will have 30 on the shot clock. You see it again, the travel by Jacksonville State.
Bronzianski had a little something to do with that. He gets the inbounds here quickly on the jumper. Doesn't get the roll, and it's taken out of there. And on the run now comes Eric Durham. Durham, a senior out of Springfield, Missouri, one of the leaders on this Jacksonville State team. They are picked 6th in the preseason poll in the OVC. which is a pretty good basketball league. There's a jumper right-hand side that goes.
Boy, nice and smooth right there by Drumright. Yeah, some teams that people have heard of before.
Murray State, of course, one of the good ones. Austin Peay as well.
Belmont.
Yep.
They've made it deep into the tournament before.
Robinson free throw, and here is a foul away from the ball. Trying to set that screen was Chris Washburn. We talked with Coach Dixon about this before the game. You see another foul here called on Washburn. He said, listen, referees are calling what you do, okay? Meaning these are things you've got to work on. And he's talked about them over and over again. And we see, again, an early foul trouble here for Washburn. It just slides a little early. You can't move like that.
He needs to just stay put. Let the contact come to you, and then you can move there. Constitutes a moving screen the way he slid over.
These are teaching moments here early on in the non-conference with this game tied at 12 now between the Frogs and the Gamecocks.
They're little detail things that are holding Washburn back right now.
And it's not as if he's not practicing well. He is, and just hasn't taken over in the games now. Penetration here by Cross doesn't go. Follow it. Bozianski fighting for it. Robinson tried to control it in the corner and does.
Oh, great effort right there by Robinson. He gets up the floor in a hurry.
Two point guards on the floor for TCU. This is Fisher, one of them. And he gets the roll. He is smooth around the rim, John, the way that ball just floats up there.
Boy, battling his way, getting knocked around all the way, and then just puts a nice little soft shot that falls for him. That's a great effort.
14-12, TCU with the early lead. Derek Green is in the lineup. He's a freshman out of Baltimore from Jacksonville State. Turn around, jump in the lane, left short this time. Back the other way. Here comes Kenrich Williams. Had it slapped away. That'll be TCU's basketball after the timeout on the floor. Kendrick trying to get in the flow of things. Been over a year since we've seen him on the floor here at TCU. Good to have him back, though. Kenrich Williams going to be a star here for the Frogs this season. They lead it here by...
Pretty good test here tonight. And next week, on Monday night, Illinois State comes to town, and then the following Friday, it's UNLV. Things get tougher, as you said, every rung on the ladder.
And you can see in November now, those weren't all cush games. He likes to throw in a tough game in November because he thinks it preps you a little bit for what happens in conference play. The Frogs will get a couple of those, as John mentioned, with Illinois State coming in on Monday, and then the two games in Vegas with UNLV and either Western Kentucky or Washington.
Yeah, those will be really good. The Frogs have a chance to play Washington twice in a row because the Huskies come here on November 30th, and we all remember last year how good they were. They gave the Frogs a headache in Seattle last year. The Frogs were never really in that game.
11:23 to play here in this first half. Kendrick Williams, only in there. Robinson operating as a point guard here. He and Fisher on the floor together. Williams baseline. Doesn't get the roll. Followed it, but Bronzianski gets petted on the tip.
Boy, Frogs all around the rim right there, and a good job by Williams following his shot as well. But Bronzianski with the tip in stretches the lead to four.
Out of the top. We'll see Gamecocks here. Just went back in. Rodzianski. Oh, not much of one there. But they're going to get the foul here. Rodzianski draws it in. Byron Jarrett, the referee, with that quick whistle.
Pretty good position right there. Rodzianski anticipating a little bit of a shiver right there with that left forearm, and he got it. He was ready to fall. Good job by Rodzianski getting that foul on Keegan.
Frogs up by four. Fisher with it. Trying to shake Kenrich Williams free again. Robinson. Washburn spins. Trying to force it. Draws contact. He'll be at the line.
It's going to be on Cunningham. That'll be his first.
Christian Cunningham, a sophomore out of Albuquerque, New Mexico. Got him in the air. Then Washburn, and then able to draw contact in the foul.
Yeah, nice move by Washburn to get his feet back underneath him so he could take advantage of Cunningham being in the air.
Tom Herrion, who sits just to the right there. Jamie Dixon forms part of this brain trust here. And I'll tell you, John, they've changed the... One of the things they've tried to do is change the attitude of guys like Chris Washburn, in that he wants Washburn. You can't get frustrated. Things aren't going your way. You know, he's had the early foul trouble that we've talked about. He wants them to keep plowing through.
Yeah, you've got to. It's a long season, and the Frogs are going to need him and his depth that he brings to the large size of the lineup.
Brodzianski blocks the attempt of Cunningham to carry him out. Now, the miss here on the jumper from Drumright, and here's Fisher on the move. Jalen lost it out of bounds. A little out of control there was Jalen Fisher.
And you want to press the tempo and force it, but you got to stay in control, especially as you get inside the free throw line. You've got to maintain control and be able to do something with the ball.
Brodzianski and Williams check out. Shepard returns for TCU, as does Malik Trent. A little smaller lineup on the floor for the Frogs right now. Fisher, Robinson, and Trent, all three out there. Greg Tucker, one of the seniors, 10 on the shot clock. He is backing it in here on Shepard. Tell you what, he did a nice job, John, drawing the double team and then finding the open man that time, and Cunningham was fouled.
There's a great pass by Giga right there, a little underhanded pass over to Cunningham, who was coming in from the right side. There you see the little dish, and they're going to get Washburn. Tough break there for Washburn. Gets caught in a tough spot right there.
Free throw off the mark here for Cunningham, a sophomore. Brandon Parrish back in for Washburn. 5-point lead for the Frogs here. Just over halfway through this opening half in Fort Worth on a Friday night. Second one rims in for him.
See if they go back inside, try to get it to Shepard, maybe.
Well, you get it there, Shepard will be careful of the rebound. Yeah, here comes Fisher's three. And off the mark on that attempt.
Frogs are not afraid to take the three tonight, Brian. That's their eighth already, seventh and eighth in that possession.
Tyreek Edwards into the lineup. Feed it this time on the move. The senior can't score at Eric Durham, but he draws contact, and he's going to be at the line now. And that's going to be on Jalen Fisher, his first. Here's another look at it, John.
Yeah, Durham is a crafty player there. You see him change hands as he floats across the lane. He's a great outside shooter, but at 6'4", he gives them a sizable point guard who can knife into the lane and is not afraid to do it. You saw it right there. He got put on the floor pretty hard.
Desmond Bain checks back into the lineup now for TCU. For Alex Robinson. Second effort is good. Jimmy Dixon's already going nine deep here in this first half. And you get the sense that's what he wants to continue to do in non-conference. Continue to play combinations as Trent can't finish, but a nice job, Shepard, to keep it alive. Parrish does finish.
Well, that rebound hit him right in the face. He's able to gather it up and get the floater to go back in. No, you're right, Brian. I think you may see him go 11, 12, 13 deep. A lot more depth this year. He's got four good guards to work with now that Michael Williams is back from injury.
And in the non-conference, why not? Right, here's ball slapped out of bounds by the Horned Frogs. Malik Trent with the quick hands there, the Big 12 leader in steals last year. Gamecocks will have the basketball with 11 on the shot clock. You see Trent knocked it away. Yeah, quick inbounds here for Cunningham to lay it in and score.
Cunningham, his first field goal of the game.
Jacksonville State in zone now. And a turnover here. Fisher telegraphed that pass. He hesitated a bit. And the indecision allowed to step into the steal here for Jacksonville State.
Yeah, looked like a freshman right there, Brian. You got to find the open guy. He tried to force it right there and turned it over. Fourth turnover of the half.
Penetration here by the freshman Green. Can't convert. Fisher back the other way. Jimmy Dixon was very complimentary of the half-court sets that you see on offense out of Jacksonville State and Ray Harper. You'll see a ton of them here tonight. You can see it's almost a set play every time down. Here's Trent for three. Malik against this zone. That's what you got to do. Shoot him out of it.
Yeah, they'll mix it up. They go into that 2-3 zone, match it up. big deep three there. That was a bomb by Trent.
Lead shoots back to five. And a travel here. Looked like he got bumped. Did Durham. Tom O'Neill said he slid the foot. Brings us to a timeout on the floor. 7-10 left in the first half. Frogs by five.
Are you
in the NFL, John? That's right. He's a football guy. And he's here tonight to support his good buddy, Jamie Dixon. That's Kevin Colbert, the GM of the Pittsburgh Steelers. And he's in town to check out Jamie Dixon's TCU Horned Frogs.
Yeah, he knows how to select personnel and get them in, catches guys on their way down. He also keeps a lot of young guys moving through the Steelers.
That's a pretty good GM, too, right there. And that's Chris Del Conte, the athletic director at TCU, whose team, of course, the football team back in action tomorrow. Oklahoma State Cowboys, that's an 11 o'clock kickoff here at Amon Carter Stadium. You can get tickets at GoFrogs.com. Kevin Colbert worked his way up as a college scout, director of pro scouting for the Detroit Lions, and then became GM of the Steelers.
How did the Lions let him get away?
That's a great question, Chip.
Jumping from the free throw line.
Knocked it in.
You might want to think about getting him back.
He's a Pittsburgh native. Went to Robert Morris there in Pittsburgh.
I think he's been to Pramani Brothers.
Yeah, I think he has.
A sandwich.
24-17 right now. And away from the ball, here is another foul on the Frogs. Calling this one fairly tight here, John, early on.
Yeah, they let him play for a while, but that one's going to be on Robinson. That'll be his first foul. They're tightening things up here as the half goes on.
Inbounds. Greg Tucker at the baseline.
Boy, nearly traveled again.
Yes, he did. Frogs aggressive defensively. A little late getting out of Giga, who could shoot it, but now another rebound for B. Robinson. Shepherd baseline. Des Bain again, pushed from behind this time. Well, it seems like he is all over the floor, John.
Yeah, he's very active, Brian. He's got great vision. Got a feel for the game. Gonna call that one on Durham. That'll be his first. Great position there on the right side, and Durham just comes right over the back there, committing the first foul.
I think he may be onto something. Feel for the game for Desmond Bain, who knows where the ball is going to be.
Can read the shot, can anticipate. The other night against Alabama State, just was effortless on his way to 19 points. Fun to watch.
Fourth team foul, by the way, on Jacksonville State. Here's Shepard. Feeds it off Bain. Robinson. Misses on the penetration there. Been fouled on the way out. Alex Robinson's going to be at the free throw line.
Yeah, Alex Robinson, not the biggest guy on the floor, Brian, but he makes a big man move right there. Down the lane in traffic. Knows he's going to get hammered. They give him a little bit of a gap to squeeze through on the left side of the lane, and, man, he's through it. Nice job.
One of two from the free throw line of the year is Alex Robinson, making now one of three. Derrick Green returns to the lineup now for Jacksonville State. And in for the first time comes Andre Statham. He's a sophomore out of Cape Girardeau, Missouri. Second free throw good here for Robinson. Frogs' largest lead of the game right now at 8.
Statham, number 33 there. Not a huge guy, but he's thick, Brian, about 240 pounds. So he gives him a little bit of heft down low.
He was an all-state football player at Cape Central High School. Pretty good basketball player as well. Worked himself into a college scholarship. Drum right, working on Trent. Baseline forces wide. Bain with another rebound.
Bain with six boards in the half.
Robinson. Yep. Too strong on the attempt, but foul. It's going to be the second here on Giga, I think. And it is.
Yeah, good work. Frogs moving the ball well, but they get it inside to Shepherd, let him go to work, and you see the foul by Giga on the arm there. Good strategy there. Giga is a weapon down low on both ends of the floor.
Free throw, Shepherd, good.
Malik Trent going to sit down. Might as well get Kenrich Williams back in the game. That's good to see.
Second effort is good here for Kavon Shepard. Jacksonville State, as we mentioned, 1-2 on the season here to start the year. Down by 10 right now to Frogs. By the way, they've got a big football game tomorrow night. Shepard here doesn't go baseline right, and let's see who they're going to call a foul on. Shepard tried to draw the charge, and I think that's what we're going to get.
Well, you can count on one or two a game from Kavon Shepard. There's another guy who's developed a feel for the game, and he knows how to anticipate. Gets over in the left block. Gets set. Tom O'Neill and staff want to look at it to make sure.
While they're taking a look at that, we mentioned the football game for TCU here tomorrow at 11 o'clock against Oklahoma State. Jacksonville State is 9-1 this year. The Gamecocks are in the OVC. And they've got Tennessee Martin tomorrow afternoon. Martin's in second place. So this is essentially, John, for the championship to win the Ohio Valley Conference. They're ranked number two in the country, by the way, on the Gamecocks in football action.
They can close it out.
There you see Shepard trying to draw that charge there.
And he does.
Yes.
Great job right there. You enjoy saying the Gamecocks are number two in the country.
Exactly. This is the, as we mentioned, the only, the second school in the country has Gamecocks as the mascot, South Carolina being the first. This is a team, by the way, that has played in the FCS National Championship game up in Frisco. Shepard jumper, does it go? Just a couple of years ago, lost that one.
It's a great event and a great venue for it up there.
In the last 5 years, they've been one of the elite teams in FCS football, North Dakota State, along with Jacksonville State and Sam Houston, really kind of been the big three. And this one knocked away in a foul here from Desmond Bain. Bain with a contact on Derek Green, the freshman out of Baltimore.
Yeah, trying to get over there to defend. Just trips him up. That's a first foul on Bain.
Just drum right out front with it. Tucker pulls the trigger on a three. Robinson with the ball.
Frogs have wanted to run. A secondary break right there. And, oh, what a good pass. Yes. Robinson faked out everybody, including Kavon Shepard.
I think Kavon thinks that Jacksonville State hit that one last, John, just by the expression on his face.
Yeah, he looks a little frustrated right there. Boy, nice job by Alex Robinson, though. Acting like he's going to slow it down, and then he hits the second gear about the time he hits the arc and just goes deep in the lane quickly.
10-point lead. Deshaun Jones with the basketball in for the first time. Almost had it knocked away. That's alone. Giga will knock down a three.
Nice shot there by Giga. That's just his second three of the year. He doesn't try a whole lot of them. 2 of 9 on the year now.
Brings a lead down to 7. Working toward 3.5 to play in the half. Jack State stays in the zone. Williams for three. There's Kenrich. First bucket, John, of over a year for Kenrich Williams.
Boy, great shot right there. He can do it all, as we mentioned. Just kind of hanging out over there about 3 o'clock on the arc and nails it. Lead back to 10.
Durham has it. And I'll leave him alone again. He'll fire another three. That one's too strong. And a fresh shot clock and a new 30 here. Green catch and shoot. Scored it. 3-pointer for the freshman.
Good pass. Cross court by Giga right there. Found Green for his first three of the year.
Robinson. Entry now to Parrish. You see Parrish playing down low, John. They're going to do more of that. They think he can play a little bigger. Here's Bank for three. Jamie Dixon wants a timeout here after that three-pointer. I don't think he liked the movement of what he saw there offensively.
Has scored. Brandon Parrish leading the way for TCU with 8 points. Desmond Bain with 7. Norbertus Giga with 7 to lead Jacksonville State.
2:32 to play in the half. Fox with a 10-point advantage. Matches the largest in a steal here. Robinson trying to add to it. To the rim.
Nice job. Just lunged, jumped out there. Took that ball. Lazy pass by Deshaun Jones. And turns it into a pair.
Skips it over deep three this time. And that one goes to answer here for Eric Durham.
Yeah, Durham likes that shot right there. They set him up nicely. It's his 10th three of the year already. 10 of 16 from three on the year for Durham.
1:58 to play. Robinson looking for Shepard down low. Williams sends it to Kavar. Jump hook in the lane. Doesn't quite get it high enough.
Needed about another inch of distance and a little more air underneath it.
Kendrick Williams with a steal. Big man running the break. Robinson. Mid-range jumper in and out. One thing Jamie Dixon does not like, John, is missed jumpers that are wide open.
Well, they had a great look right there. You've got to nail those down.
Nice pass from the big man there to finish. Andre Stepp.
Boy, Giga showed us something tonight, Brian. He has four assists already in the game.
1:05 to go. Lead has been trimmed to 7. Bain left alone. Missed that one. He made one from there previously in the half. And a timeout taken here by Ray Harper. His use it or lose it 30 taken. For Jacksonville State with 48.7 left in the half.
With Fogs are going to get another shot at the basketball here before the half's over.
Jacksonville State with it. 7-point game. Deep three here, and he banked it in to Statham. Not so sure that's what they drew up, but it counts nonetheless.
And he will take him. Sixth of the year for him. Basket stanchion still rattling.
35-31, a 4-point game. Now the 20 seconds to play in this half. And against this zone, they get it in the high post to Shepard. Kenrich Williams for three from the corner. Short, but he's fouled. The 13.1 to play in the half. That'll put Kenrich on the line for three and a break there for the Frogs.
Yeah, no doubt about it. Didn't look like he was quite set, but the foul also may have had something to do with the shot being short. Kenrich usually is not short with those jumpers. He'll go to the line.
Williams misses the first one. And the second.
Well, as you mentioned, it's his first game in a year, Brian. Going to take a little while to get the rust off. Good to get him some game action.
He was a 61% free throw shooter a couple of years ago, was Kendrick. Makes 1 of 3. Malik Trent's going to check in now. For Fisher. 11.8 left. Jalen Fisher sits. Now in the final 10 seconds of the half.
You gotta watch out for Tucker in the corner. They want him with the ball.
Out top, senior fires a three, doesn't get the roll, and the lead will be 5. Heading into the locker room for TCU. Frogs led by as many as 12, John, late in this first half, but a run there. For Jack, game number 3 in the Jamie Dixon era. Men's basketball action tonight. For the Horned Frogs, the women are back in action against SMU on Sunday at 2 o'clock. First 500 fans will receive a free T-shirt. You can buy your tickets for that game at GoFrogs.com. Great women's basketball rivalry there.
Yeah, and SMU, a good team. They're undefeated, just like the Lady Frogs are. That'll be a great one Sunday afternoon. Jamie Dixon, final encouragement to his team as they get ready to start the second half here. And we talked about going to the break, intensity and effort. Jacksonville. State, hanging with the Frogs here, down just fine.
You know, in that last game for TCU against Alabama State, he loved the way his team played in the first half, but he thought they let off the gas in the second half. They said, hey, that's a real teaching moment for us. Here's a three-pointer to start the second
for the Gamecocks, and that one comes from Drumright. And all of a sudden, you're looking at a two-point ball game.
Yeah, tightens things up in a hurry.
Here's Fisher. Trent. Fisher lost it. Shepard can't finish. And two tries at it. Kavar ends up on the floor.
A lot of contact there.
But Shepard got his money's worth on the block. Are they going to call a foul here? Because he ran the floor. And they are going to call the foul on Kavar on the block of Giga. John, here's the sequence. And now we got a little pushing and shoving going on. But here's the sequence. So Kavar runs the floor, and you see him get his money's worth there. They're going to call the foul. Now put him in the act to put him at the line.
Yeah, got a little heated there. In the previous possession for TCU, a lot of contact. And I think that's what got Kavar's ire up. Also got a discussion from Jamie Dixon in front of us right now talking to Tom O'Neill.
Here's a look at it, John. All right, this is a sequence that we're talking about. Here's the first part. So Kavar misses here. Misses here. Thought he was bumped. Ends up on the ground after the push. And then is able to run the floor here to get that block that led to this foul. And the free throw missed by Giga.
And on the replay, it looked like it was Cunningham who got more of Kavar than Giga. But yep, nonetheless, those were the two that were jawing at the end of the play a moment ago.
Gamecocks have cut this down to a one-point game. Parrish, three-pointer from the corner.
Oh, a nice catch and shoot there by Parrish. His third three of the game. That's huge.
Now top with it. Works drum right. And away from the ball here. Let's see. Fisher was in chase of Tucker. And now Giga's being talked to by the official.
Tom O'Neill explaining it to Ray Harper, the head coach of Jacksonville State as well.
Fisher whistled for the personal. It's his second. And now with possession of his Jacksonville State again. Out of bounds it goes, they say, off of Fisher. It'll stay with the Gamecocks.
Well, if the Frogs had any concern about not being into it here in the early part of the second half, things have gotten stoked up in a hurry. Nice job by Fisher there getting a hand on the inbounds pass.
90 seconds into this second half. Here for three. Fisher with a move. Not the shot that they wanted. And here is a foul. And Shepard tied up with Giga running the floor, and he's whistled for the personal foul.
There's a lot of talking going on right now between Shepard and Giga. Back down on the other end of the floor. They're going to get Giga out of it. It's when they're running back down in the center of your screen, when they're running back down the floor as Fisher's bringing it up. They start talking early on and then start bumping, and Giga gets nailed for the foul.
Parrish, another three. Lead to seven.
Big critical point of the foul on Giga, Brian. That's his third.
On the perimeter with a hand check. I tell you, this game's getting more physical, John, with every possession now between these two teams. There's a second whistle on Malik Trent.
Yeah, getting a little more intense, trying to deny the lane there. Trent stepping out. Not a bad foul.
Drum right with it out front.
Teams are picking up the pace, though, and it's getting more and more physical.
Yep. Tucker
And a reach in here. No, let's see. Is this going to be on Fisher or Trent? It's going to be on Fisher, and that's his third.
Well, he'd gotten away with a bump earlier when the ball was out front. And here with the drive by Tucker.
Now it's Robinson checks in now. Now front working with it now. Cutting in the lane goes drum right again and another foul. And a foul here. On Malik Trent, his third.
Yeah, that's... Clock suddenly getting some people into foul trouble, and it's two guards. That's not good.
.42-36 with that made free throw. Malik Trent has to check out. Kenrich Williams comes in. Second free throw is good. 5-point game.
Jacksonville State going back to that zone here early in the second half.
Here's Williams. Now Bain. Robinson, Williams from the corner. Kendrick's knocks in a three.
Good ball movement. They reverse the ball, get Williams open. That's his second three of the game.
Lead gets to eight, 45-37. Remember, this Jacksonville State team won on the road at Tulsa this year already. The Golden Hurricane in a bit of a rebuilding project there, but nonetheless, to go there and win is always a tough task.
Yeah, tough place to play.
Free throw line jumper here, score it this time for Jakara Cross.
Yeah, big high arcing shot right there. Gets it to fall through. Jacksonville State, got to give them credit, Brian. They keep answering.
45-39 against this zone now. Parrish, Robinson. Baseline left, Shepard. Skip it to Robinson again. Nice look. Parrish can't finish. Follows his shot, though, and scored. Jimmy Dixon wanted foul on the first contact.
Yeah, he could have called, could have been a foul on both.
And a turnover here, thrown away by Drumright. And the Frogs will have it after the timeout on the floor. The intensity continuing to increase here for the
end event. And see why Ford is the best in Texas.
Frogs have stretched the lead out to eight right now on Jacksonville State. 47-39. It was a 5-point game at the half. Three balls been falling for the Frogs here in the second half, but both teams have cranked up the defensive pressure.
Yeah, Frogs have made 3 of 3 from beyond the arc, and it is getting very, very physical. Some players starting to get into foul trouble. The Frogs with a couple of guards, Jalen Fisher and Malik Trent, with 3 fouls each. The big man, Norbertus Giga, has 3 fouls for Jacksonville State. He's on back out on the floor.
Greg Tucker, they get it down low, cross, put it up off the glass, followed his own shot, missed them both, and Shepard's there for the rebound.
Cross is a strong player, Brian. I don't know how he got that shot off right there.
Robinson tried to force it and then commits the foul. And he turns right to Jamie Dixon, knowing exactly what he had done. Turnover here, then commits a second personal foul. Here's another look at him.
Well, Tucker's a good player, anticipated that pass, trying to go a bounce pass to his left. And Robinson gets his pocket picked and has to foul him out of frustration. Turnover number 6 by TCU.
Left-hand side with it now. They get it out top here to Cross. From right. Penetrates. Giga can't handle it. From right claims it down to 8 on the shot clock. the clock. Forces a deep three for the left side that doesn't go. With a rebound and a new 30 here. After the miss by Tucker.
Yeah, Durham scrambles, gathers it up in the corner.
Drumright again, this time with the left hand over Robinson, got it to go.
Yeah, Drumright, good strong drive there by the guard. Plays, talk about a guy that plays bigger than he is. He's only 6'2", but does a nice job.
He's a big-time scorer in high school. In California, 21 points a game at Rancho Cucamonga. Baseline left, Shepard, no look, finds Williams cutting for the three.
Straight down the lane. Great job by Shepard. Williams with that one. He's got nine, Brian.
8-point lead now. 6 minutes into the second half. And a foul here, an offensive foul. And this one is on Greg Tucker. John, we've seen that more in the first three games of this year than maybe all of last year combined.
Well, that's some of what Jamie Dixon and his staff are teaching, Brian. If they pick the ball up and hold it, Frogs are going to jump out on him. He holds the ball right there, and there's Kenrich Williams. Frustrated Tucker, and he committed the foul. First foul on Tucker. That's just great defense right there.
Williams thought about it, penetrates here. Takes him to the baseline. Oh, trying to give it up to Shepard. Block right back to it. Now forced to turn around. It doesn't get the roll. Follow for Shepard. No, but a foul here on Jacksonville State. It's a real advantage, Sean, when you can play Williams and Shepard together on the floor.
Yeah, you got two very athletic players that can fly around the rim. And you see Williams getting the shot. And then Kavar trying to go back up. I'm not sure that foul was on the floor, man.
They caught it right away on the floor, though. And so the Frogs inbounds. And here's another foul committed as Shepard falls down. As Greg Tucker just runs right through it. I'll tell you, Jacksonville State playing with a bit of an attitude here in the second half.
Yeah, they sure are. Tucker's picked up two quick fouls. Can't afford to get too many guys in foul trouble, Brian. They only play really about seven guys.
Let's see if we can catch this here. There he's just running right through Kavar Shepard with that left forearm. Change their half-court set here. Jacksonville State back to the man-to-man. Here's a deep three. Parrish short on it and knew it. Egan with a rebound.
Good job by Robinson finding the open man. That was Parrish.
Lead stays at 8 for TCU. Steal here, Parrish. And the open floor, Brandon.
Good defense. Frogs jump out, confuse the backcourt there, force the turnover. Great job right there. Eighth turnover by Jack.
The way it's a little different approach when it comes to scoring in this game, Doug.
Yeah, no doubt about it. He's got 18 tonight. Five-plus players scored double figures for the Frogs in the first two games. Desmond Bain, Jalen Fisher open their careers with back-to-back outings of 10-plus points, and you see Brandon Parrish taking the lead tonight. The Frogs are sharing the ball. It's a different guy every night, it seems.
Parrish, the only one in double digits so far. 9, though, for Williams as well for TCU. Long-range jumper doesn't go. This one goes out of bounds, and a foul here on the rebound, and let's see. And this foul is going to be charged to Christian Cunningham. May have lost a contact as well.
Yeah, he's going to sit down.
Either he lost a contact or he got popped in the nose. Yeah, that may have been what it was. Yep.
Yeah, got a solid shot right in the nose.
And I think we've got some blood on the floor here, so he has to check out. And the injury timeout here with 12:33 to go. Tom O'Neill, the referee, saying, hey, what we got going on here? And there's some blood on the court here after that shot to the nose on Christian Cunningham. So timeout for them to clean that up here with 12:30. UNLV, Western Kentucky. or Washington would be that second game opponent. That's coming up Friday and Saturday of this week. So they take care of the floor, and we're ready to go. Johan Wang there, the basketball trainer, claimed the floor up. Came for TCU from the Golden State Warriors. Here's Robinson. Three-pointer.
They leave him alone. Back off, and he makes them pay. First three of the night. Frogs are shooting it great from the arc, Brian. 9 of 16 on the game.
Largest lead of the game now. 54-41, TCU with the advantage. Stayed with it out front now. For Jacksonville State. Tucker on the move. 10 on the shot clock. Slapped away by Washburn on the overplay.
Read that one and got a hand in there. Great play by Washburn.
Here's Williams. Wash with a jump hook short. And a foul here. Let's see if they call this on Stadium, and they do. Stadium. Frogs will have the basketball when we come back. 54-41 right now. It's a 13-point TCU lead. Largest of the game. Their largest lead of the game. TCU volleyball back in action. Their next match against West Virginia at 7 o'clock. That'll be senior night, of course. Find out more at GoFrogs.com to purchase your tickets. First 200 fans, by the way, at that match.
It's a raucous environment over there at University Rec Center. That's Coach Kramer's old team.
Yes, it is.
West Virginia and Lady Mountaineers.
That's happening Wednesday night, senior night. Jamie Dixon looks on here as Chris Washburn heads to the free throw line. Frogs with that 13-point margin. Ray Harper's team had this game down to 2 in the second half.
Yeah, first possession of the second half. They cut it to 2. Frogs have come back, hit 4 or 5 threes here in the second half. Built this lead up.
14 now. Tucker. Out front. Frogs the man-to-man working on Kendrick Williams here. The other thing that the Frogs have forced Jacksonville State to do, John, is work this shot clock way down low. 5 right now. Baseline jumper goes this time for Drumright.
Hanging jumper right there. He's got 14. Put together a nice game, Brian. Leads Jacksonville State in scoring. 14 tonight.
At 20 in the win against Tulsa. Here's Parrish. Nice move there by Grant to find the open spot against that defense and knock in the mid-range jumper.
Yeah, he wanted to go 3 first, and then, as you said, found the open spot, then a mid-range jumper, knocks it down, gets to 20. Huge night for him.
Lead back to 14 now. This is the 100th game that Brandon Parrish has played in his career.
And he's celebrating tonight. He's having a great night.
Kavar Shepherd, by the way, with the start tonight. Works himself into the top 10 all-time in career starts at TCU. A foul here. Pretty good job there defensively by Brandon Parrish. But he's going to be whistled for the personal. So another look at it. Let's see if he's got him on the guard.
Good hustle play.
Yep.
Yeah, just got him barely. That'll be the second on Brandon Parrish.
Ja'Cora Cross, pretty good-looking freshman out of Lithonia, Georgia, knocks in the first one. All-stater there, played at Lithonia High School, also a couple of years at Cedar Grove High School as well. Missed the second free throw. Point margin. Working ourselves to halfway through this second half. Trent penetrates his zone. A little out of control there. He got lucky here. His Cross late sliding over. That'll put Malik at the free throw line for a 1-on-1 opportunity.
Cross nearly got there. Good aggressive play, though, forcing the issue by Malik Trent.
A couple of substitutions as Derek Green returns to the lineup for Tucker. Also in comes Christian Cunningham. Took the shot to the nose early on. Malik Trent misses that free throw. On the front end of the one-on-one. Frogs have been in the man-to-man the entire game tonight.
Yeah, we've not seen any zone out of TCU.
That would be the preference of Jamie Dixon. There may be some special moments when you see zone. Here's a nice follow that time for it.
Yeah, a little breakdown on the baseline there that is not going to make Jamie Dixon real happy.
Magnesia scores. Should. You really
think should. Think they give me 55 foam fingers?
Yeah, they might.
That's a lot of foam fingers.
They probably 55 cupcakes.
Like I need those.
57-46, 11-point lead for TCU. The timeout taken by Jamie Dixon. Let's see what he does here at the half court. Fisher, now Robinson.
Yeah, back to that zone again for Jacksonville State. I think I'd go down low, try to go to down, work on Giga, see if he can get him a fourth foul.
Bronzianski in, got it right back from Fisher. And a foul here.
There you go.
Yep. Got the foul on it.
Right side, Fisher. Boy, he's got a quick wrist. Lasers it in there to Bojanski, who draws a foul. As you said, four now on Giga.
Free throw good for Bojanski. Made them both, good plan. ...59-46, 13-point margin. 9 minutes left in this one. Baseline jumper that goes. Pretty good shot there for Malcolm Drumright. As you said, Johnny continues to add to his numbers.
Quietly just building a great night tonight. He's 6 of 11 from the floor for 16 points. Couple of threes.
Shepherd in the high post. Looks down low. Bolsianski.
Attacking Giga, all he can do is just stand there. Can't get too aggressive defensively or he'll foul out. Bojanski with 6 points in the game.
Back to 13 on the lead. Durham gives it back down to Drumright. Back to Durham. Baseline, what a block there. That's Robinson. He'll get credit for the block. Fisher back the other way.
Great job there by Robinson. Just got a hand all ball right there. Like the way the Frogs are swarming to the basketball, Brian.
Fisher. High post catch bang. Fisher again. He knocked in a three.
Fisher finally getting in the act. His first three of the night, Brian.
Largest lead of the game for TCU now at 16.
59% from beyond the arc for the Frogs. They've hit 10 threes tonight.
Penetrates, knocked away again, no call. Fisher almost lost it. Bain keeps it himself and scores.
Roger in rhythm right now. Bain with his ninth point of the night.
Timeout on the floor, 7:25 to go. In this one, Horned Frogs with a lead, 66-48 right now. Lead of the game.
He's got the beat.
Yes, he does.
So does Brandon Parrish. Four threes on the night for Brandon Parrish, Brian. He's flirting with a career high. Career high is 22 points. He has 20 right now. Done it all over the floor, but he's been deadly tonight from beyond the arc.
His third career 20-point game here.
Got it done inside, too, with some putbacks. Steel running the floor in his first start of the night. He's celebrating it. There's the first start of the season.
Yep. Down low. You can't get that when it goes out of bounds, and they say it's going to be TCU's basketball. Last to touch it for the Gamecocks.
Boy, Frogs have turned up the heat defensively, Brian. Doing a nice job. They've forced 11 turnovers by Jacksonville State, and they're denying shots right now. Jacksonville State having a hard time getting shots off.
Rozyansky, corner right, it goes to Robinson. Back now to Fisher. They'll give here Robinson. He'll fire the jumper off the mark. Tapped around a couple of times out of bounds to the TCU bench. And let's see. Jamie Dixon thinks this could be TCU's basketball. And here comes the Gamecocks.
Most of the people in the building agreed with Jamie Dixon.
Out front, Durham. To go, Shepard.
Yeah, Shepard slipped down. He lost his footing, Brian. Cunningham just backs out and hits a little jumper.
6:05 to go. Foul out front here. Derrick Green with a hand check of Robinson. Another look at it, John. You just can't do that.
Yeah, jumped right on top of him. Hit him. Kind of put a lid on him there. Green getting in the game. Doesn't get a whole lot of minutes. He plays 10 minutes a game. Picks up a quick foul right there.
Robinson's first free throw is good. Misses the second attempt. Lead is 17 for TCU. Under 6 minutes to go. Sean Jones back in at one of the guards right now for Jacksonville State. Nice penetration there for the finish for Greg Tucker.
A little breakdown there. Took Jalen Fisher to school. 5 points for Fisher in the game.
Lead at 15. They look for Bain baseline. Finishes it and foul. That's Tucker's personal. His third, and Bain will be at the line with a chance for a three-point play here.
Boy, good job by Bain. You see him hanging out on the baseline down the right block. Quick pass inside. Tucker can't believe he got called for the foul.
Yeah, there was a lot of contact there. It is now an 18-point ball game, 70-52. Sean Jones, they get the alley-oop they wanted on the set play here. Unable to finish that time was Cunningham.
Beat him back door and just couldn't handle the pass.
Brodzianski for three. Shepard can't get the rebound. Cunningham does. Off of the corner, Green. He'll pull the trigger short on the attempt. But Fisher's going to be whistled for the personal foul. I get the sense, John, that Jamie Dixon's not real happy with Jalen Fisher's defense here tonight.
Yeah, he's struggling a little bit. You saw him a minute ago get beat on the drive. There he reaches in. Just a little bit of a graze, but picks up his fourth foul.
Green misses the free throw. Fisher's going to check out. We're going to see Mike Williams for the first time this year, John.
Good to see him back. Had a little bit of a sore left ankle. Missed the first couple of games, but he's another guy as an experienced guard, Brian. Frogs with Fisher and Robinson. And now you put in Michael Williams. Yeah, they've got four solid guards.
70-53, under 5 minutes to go. Here's Robinson baseline. Looks for Shepard. Kavar put it on the floor. And it's taken away here by Jacksonville State.
Kavar was determined to get a shot off there.
We've got a shot clock issue, so they had to stop play. On the shot clock here. They'll change it. 4:39 left. Jacksonville State with the basketball. Here's a deep three again. This one doesn't go for Tucker this time. Two frogs there, and Robinson comes out of there.
Yeah, good job blocking out there by TCU, Shepard and Robinson.
Skip pass, Williams. Kavar in the lane. Brodzianski tried to follow it, had his pocket picked, but a foul here. And this one, I think, is going to be on Tucker again. Let's see. It is on Tucker, his fourth.
Yeah, Vlad in good position there on the left side of the lane. Tucker has stacked up three quick fouls, Brian.
Brodzianski at the line for two, first one. You see some Brodzianski fans. He's a favorite on campus, too, by the way.
Great guy, great young man.
Good student. Brodzianski makes a second.
He's put on a little weight this year, a little larger through the shoulders. That'll serve him well.
4 minutes left. Frogs with a 19-point advantage. Jones penetrates. Giga lost it. Parrish fighting or making Bain fighting for it. Heads up play to tap it forward to Williams. He's got Shepard instead. Pulls it out wisely. There's a senior move, by the way.
Yeah, let's just settle it down. Let's get set up here. No need to force anything.
Here's Williams with it. Robinson. Around Shepard left alone. Mike Williams for the jumper off the mark. And the rebound here, Jack State. In the forecourt. Lost out of bounds, and let's see. It's going to stay here with the Gamecocks, I do believe, after the timeout of the floor. 3:11 to play. And Wilkerson Grinison, of course, remember the undefeated season, John, in non-conference where the Frogs go 14-0, won a tournament down in Corpus Christi. And even in 13-14, 9-3 non-conference record. So, but then you get into the Big 12 play.
The challenge is to, and you said it, Jamie Dixon has kind of turned up the heat with every non-conference game they play to get ready. You want to transfer that momentum into conference play because that's a tough one. I mean, best basketball conference in America.
Inbounds for Jack State with 15 on the shot clock. Here's a three from the corner that doesn't go this time. For Durham, and the Frogs will push now. Williams, nice look ahead to Brodzianski. Slapped away and taken away by Tucker. Durham. Dishes. Shuffling his feet before the three. Egan turns it over.
Trying to gather himself. Pretty aggressive play by Tucker down the floor. I'm going to go with four fouls.
Ray Harper says he never shuffled. So he got the ball down before that second step, or the third, I should say. Here's Shepard. Bain. Frogs in movement here offensively. Robinson left alone. The rebound here, Jacksonville State. May have shot that a little early for Jamie Dixon.
Yeah, at this point in the game, work the shot clock down a little bit.
Three-pointer in the corner. That's Drum Wright again.
Drum Wright, 19. It's his third three of the game.
72-56, Robinson Williams.
He's going to run the offense a little bit here.
Robinson to the rim.
Nope.
Made that too difficult, Johnny. Didn't need to reverse it. Could have easily laid it up.
And a clear path to the bucket.
Back the other way, Brodzianski blocks it. Only attempt by Tucker. Another look at it.
Nice job avoiding the foul. Long arms go to work right there. The Frogs have three blocks tonight, Brian, and Vlad has all three.
1:50 left. Make it four. Williams the other way. Mike on the push. Had it slapped away from behind. Brandon Perry Parrish going to check into the TCU lineup now. Let's see who he comes in for. Brodzianski. Great minutes off the bench for Vlad.
Great minutes. See, he and Shepard both going up to deny the shot, get the block.
I think both of them got a piece of it. You can see the smile from Vlad. He knew it. Down to 130 to play in this one. Williams. Deep three here now. Robinson, he knocked that one down.
He's been wanting one of those. Took one earlier. It's his second of the night. Frogs 11th as a team.
Takes a lead back to 19. Keegan misses, but it's fouled here, and I think that's going to be on Desmond Bain, who got a piece of it with a minute six to go. And it is. He'll go to the line for a pair.
The Frogs with some swagger here in the second half defensively, Brian. They are all over the ball, getting blocks, doing a great job.
First free throw is good for Gigas. Shepard will check out. Kavar sits. As Chris Washburn will come in for him. Minute six left in this ballgame. Kavar, another good outing here tonight. Maybe not as big of a point total, John, but efficient when he was out there. 6 points and four boards. Had four assists as well. Here, Kavar Shepard. Here's Baker the rim.
Made that look easy, didn't he, Brian? 14 points for Bain tonight.
Largest lead of the game. Deep three here, stepping into this one. Got it to go. You're at Durham.
Good-looking guard. That gets him to double figures with 11 points.
Lead down to 17 again. About a 14-second differential between this game clock and the shot clock. Robinson leaves for Washburn in the lane, who hesitates and then scores him with the right hand.
Nice work working over Giga again, who can only stand there and watch.
Shot clock is off now. Sean Jones. Another three that doesn't go this time for Durham, and the Frogs will hold it, and that'll do it. 3-0 to start the season for Jamie Dixon's team, John. Pretty good outing here tonight. One of those where the schedule got tougher. Frogs responded. He wanted to see more in the second half, and I think he got it here tonight.
Yeah, I think so. They got